Doctor, doctor, I feel like watching Operation Ouch. You can watch them now on the free BBC iPlayer app.
Please welcome to the lab, Ozzy Ossicles.
Are you ready to work?
Yes!
Are you ready to do an experiment to demonstrate the possibility of acoustic damage to the cochlea?
It's Ozzy Ossicles. Don't worry, it's me. I have made a very simplified model of the human middle and inner ear. So imagine there's a big ear out here, and that catches the sound waves and directs them down the ear canal towards the eardrum or tympanic membrane. When the sound waves hit the eardrum, they make it wobble. When the eardrum wobbles, it moves the ossicles, the three bones in your middle ear. The malleus wobbles and hits the incus. Next, the incus wobbles and makes the stapes wobble. And then the stapes moves against the cochlea, which turns the sound into an electrical signal and sends it to your brain.
OK, Xand, let's see it in action. Why don't we start with a quiet sound?
Here we go. So, if we imagine a sound wave arriving at the tympanic membrane, the air molecules, which are represented by these pink ping pong balls, start to vibrate back and forth, and they tap on the tympanic membrane, passing a small amount of energy between the bones, and the stapes taps lightly on the cochlea so there's no damage.
Let's see what happens when a sound wave with more energy hits the eardrum.
Let's flare up some big sound waves down the ear canal.
Now the eardrum is moving more, and that's moving the ossicles more, so more energy is being passed along. And now the stapes is hitting the cochlea even harder. And Xand, it's hitting it so hard, I'm worried it might be about to damage it.
But you have an amazing job, Chris, which will help prevent damage because you are the acoustic reflex. Here we go. Let's make a louder noise.
I'm holding two red strings. This one is the tensor tympani, and this one is the stapedius, and they're muscles attached to two of the ossicles, and I'm pulling them tight, stopping them moving.
So less energy gets moved from the eardrum through to the cochlea, and so there's less risk of damage. Chris, this is working brilliantly. Your acoustic reflex does an amazing job. Brilliant work, Chris. But sometimes sounds can be so loud, it's too much energy for your acoustic reflex to cope with, and it can damage the cochlea. Chris, it's time to unleash Armageddon!
Are you sure about this, Xand?
Absolutely sure, Chris. But first, I need to modify the stapes.
Here's an operation you must perform. Head to wherever you download your apps, download the free BBC iPlayer app now, and watch brand new Operation Ouch.
Well, there we go, Chris. A new stapes with pins in it.
Pins, balloon, spells disaster.
Exactly, Chris. Time to crank it up to 11! Woo! It's gonna go. And that is why you have to be careful around loud noises. Prolonged exposure can damage your cochlea. Now, it's not going to explode like that, but if you're ever told to wear ear defenders or headphones specially designed for children, make sure you wear them. But then you can rock out!
So we've shown you that sound travels in waves. Quiet sounds have waves with a low peak and carry small amounts of energy, and loud sounds have waves with tall peaks that carry lots of energy. Too much energy can damage your cochlea.
And that you have two amazing bits of body kit called the tensor tympani and stapedius muscles, and they help prevent too much energy being passed by your ossicles to your cochlea, reducing the risk of loud noises damaging it.
Well, all this has put me in the mood for playing with my favourite blue giant balloon, if you'll excuse me.
Where did I put it?
I really do love that balloon. I wonder where it could be.
Ouch! Oh, I think I've got a fever. BBC iPlayer app fever. I've just downloaded it for free to watch brand new Operation Ouch whenever I want, and you should do it too.